Hey, Stacy. I've been hearing some kind of crazy news in the air, and I'm calling to confirm it. There's something going on that you need to tell me. Stacy, I like a loyal side chick. You're using my husband, and the last thing I need from you is for you to be lying to me. Do you understand me? Something's going on. Please tell me what it is. Nothing? Okay, let me just get to the point because I know. So let me be the one to tell you. You are pregnant for my husband, Benedict. You how dare you? I told all of y'all side chick, if my husband ever come to y'all and he doesn't have protection, kick him out. Let me know. And then, just out of respect, just out of loyalty, man. So, but no, some of y'all just too greedy. Y'all just want too much. Now you're pregnant for my husband. Oh, yes, you are. Because the clinic you went to and got your result, my sister worked there and she knows exactly who you are. She knows you. You think this thing, yeah, I just keep it to myself? No, my whole family know who all the side chicks that Benedict mess with, who they know other y'all. So, why? Why, Stacy? No, before you start crying, let me tell you something. Get serious and wipe those tears away because we need to discuss what's going to happen, okay? And I'm going to tell you what's about to happen. You are automatically a surrogate mother. Do you understand? Surrogate mother. The child in your belly is for me. That's my baby. Ridiculous, my fault. Let me ask you, is Benedict your husband? No, he's not your husband, eh? He's my husband. Look, Stacy, it's not like you went to the sperm bank and got some unknown person's sperm and you got pregnant with that. No, that's my husband's sperm. So every reproductive cell that comes out of his body, I own it, okay? His offspring becomes mine, okay? So you're gonna have that child and you're gonna give that child to us so we can raise that child in this holy matrimonial home, in a home where that child belongs, where that child needs to know his or her siblings. Do you understand? If you don't have any child. If you wanted to have child, I marry man, you are gonna you see to choose to have your baby with, huh? You couldn't get your own man, yeah? That's my child, Stacy. Okay, everything on Benedict from head to toes, I own it. Even the fluids out of his body, that's mine. That's my baby, Stacy. That's my baby. Okay, you are automatically a surrogate mother. So when you have that child, that baby is mine, free of charge. We're not paying you anything because I'm sure maybe I will reconsider on the second child. But this one, I'm taking it from you. I'm taking it from you. You have no say. You have no say. Don't even think about doing nothing crazy because I have a plan B. And look, you say when you have a plan B, you don't talk about it. You don't talk about it because the plan B is meant to conquer and scatter everything that will even stand in the way. So don't play with me. Oh. Don't play with me. I will take that child from you and we'll put you on child support. Now, don't stop crying, yo. Don't stop. No, we're not talking to Benedict about this. We're not talking to Benedict about this, okay? You should have confronted me when Benedict wasn't using protection. Then we wouldn't be having this conversation, okay? So you don't even have a husband. You don't have a fiance. You don't have anybody. You're just a single woman, okay? Then you want to raise my child in your unstable home? No, you're gonna give me my child, okay? I already wanted one. Thank you, thank you, thank you for having one for me. I'm getting my child from you. I'm getting my child from you. I'm done with this conversation.